Hey everybody, Renegade 410 here with a part two to my description of double action only, single action only, and double action, single action firearms. We just wrapped up talking about this, the SIG 226, which is the double action only gun. What we're going to do now is we're going to move into a different firearm that combines the attributes of both the double action and the single action, and we'll give you a little bit of an idea of what's going on with that. What we have here is a firearm that has both attributes of the double action and the single action, making it a double action, single action operation. As you can tell, slides back, chamber's empty, magazine well is empty, I have safety checked the weapon. What we have here is a Walther P22, it's a 22 caliber pistol. This particular version is, again, like I said, the double action, single action type of a weapon. What we're going to do is we're going to demonstrate what I mean by that now. I'm going to take the slide, I'm going to let the slide go forward, and what you see here is something that we've seen already, right? We have the hammer back, and what appears to be a relatively short trigger pull. This is what you would see after you've actually fired the weapon or placed a round into the chamber. What we're going to do is, as you can see here, this is the magazine. It is empty. There are no rounds in that. And we're going to insert this into the weapon because this particular sidearm has a magazine disconnect, which means as much as I want to pull the trigger, it won't go off because that's a safety mechanism. The magazine must be in the firearm to make it go, to allow the trigger to drop the hammer, to strike the firing pin, to fire the cartridge. I don't particularly like that myself. I feel that's a little too much for me, but lots of people do. Corrections officers are usually required to have that type of thing on their firearms and stuff like that. I'm not, but this particular gun, something I wanted. It's a 22, so it's cheap to buy. It's inexpensive. It's not cheap. The ammo is cheap, however. You can shoot all day long for just a few bucks with a 22, and it's fun. It's nice, not a whole lot of recoil, but that's review. That's not what we're talking about here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this into a double action mode, meaning that we either did one of two things. Again, when you do that, when you release a hammer down onto the firearm, any firearm, you need to observe all the safety precautions, preferably having the magazine out of the weapon, making sure there's no round in the chamber. If that's not possible, making sure the weapon is in a safe direction, making sure you have lots and lots of practice, making sure that you know how to do that without it going off. I do. I've been doing that for a while. I've practiced with this firearm. I've practiced with my 1911, so I know that what I'm doing is not going to damage the firearm. The other thing about a 22 is I'm not going to dry fire this as I did with the other ones because the firing pin can damage the chamber on the inside, which actually happened to me in another firearm. But, what we have here is what would be considered the double action mode. Again, long, stiff trigger, bringing the hammer back. If it was to get all the way to completion, the trigger pull, the hammer would disengage, drop, strike the firing pin, which would strike the cartridge. The projectile would then exit the barrel. This would cycle back, it would cycle forward, and we'd be in the single action mode, which means the hammer's back, and there's a relatively short trigger pull. I'm going to reinsert the magazine there so we can show you what I'm talking about. If I was to do that, I'm going to, again, hang on to the hammer. So you could see, you pull the trigger, and there it goes. It would go, it would drop, it would strike, and the entire process would repeat. That's the combination of the double action and the single action. As you can see there, we'll bring the SIG 226 back in. Okay, still safety checked. You can see that how it has that long trigger pull from here. Same type of trigger pull on the Walther in the double action mode. The attributes of a double action, single action would be that first shot, if you take this, you load it, or any double action, single action, if it was say a double action, single action 226, you would do that. You'd load it, cycle around, extract your magazine, administratively load the last round into the magazine, reseat the magazine, you'd have that hammer down. You would decock it, which would drop it into a double action mode, giving it certain inherent safety characteristics. Again, ones that I feel aren't 100% necessary for everyone. I do carry that single action firearm a lot, and I'm comfortable with it and its safety features. The double action only, what that does is that removes certain safety features, as having to disengage a manual safety, a little bit less you have to learn, a little bit less training. This has a manual safety, as you can see here, safe and fire. That's good, especially on a recreation or learning tool as this would be. This is a great 22 of any variety, not just the Walther, but of any variety, is a great way to train someone who's new to firearms. If your children are old enough in your mind to begin to learn how to handle these things, which I believe that all children should absolutely 100% learn how to handle and understand a firearm, then this is a great way to start. I mean, the 22 is great. I actually have pellet guns. I've had pellet guns and BB guns, and it's almost the same amount of recoil. I mean, but this is the real deal. So, great learning tool for anyone. I've trained adults, trained young adults on them, and you know what? They're great. But the double action, single action of that, again, kind of idiot proofs. I don't want to say that in. That's kind of a tongue-in-cheek thing, an idiot-proof, but it makes it harder for this to accidentally be discharged, which I don't think there's any good reason for an accidental discharge. It just shouldn't happen. That's user error. And you know what? If there's user error in something like that, you shouldn't be using it. So, but that's the general overview of a double-action, single-action. This, as I said, does not have a decocking mechanism of any sort, but that's because it is what it is. The small gun, it's a 22. Things like that. You're not really expecting this necessarily to be carried, although it can, and I'll explain that in a later video. The double action only, which is my service weapon, and of course the single action only, which would be represented here by the 1911. Okay guys, that's, I'm sure, more than enough of your time that I've just taken up explaining and probably repeating myself. So if you guys are in any kind of confusion or anything, please leave me a comment. Let me know. I'll be glad to get to the comments and try and explain anything further to you. If you liked the video, both parts, please, by all means, leave me a comment. Let me know if you didn't. By all means, let me know how I can improve. Other than that, you guys stay safe out there.